I wonder if it would be beneficial, since a lot of this work tends to be online through written communication more than an in-person thing, is if you have a new client that you do something like either on the phone or on like a Zoom or Skype call in the beginning, because otherwise what I've found, when, especially when you're dealing with anything on in social media, Facebook, any of that stuff, people have a tendency to put whatever they're currently feeling onto the person as they're reading their, what they've written. So if somebody is angry, they are going to put that anger and fit it into what they're reading so that they feel like the person that they're, who's making the comment is angry when they're not. And if you have that first, at least an initial face-to-face of some sort where they can see how you speak, hear how you speak, see your mannerisms and stuff, and it's a nice, pleasant conversation, they'll have that to draw on when you're speaking and giving them a critique of some sort. They aren't going to automatically think that you're being critical or criticizing, and instead, hey, he seemed pretty nice, so he's probably coming off pretty nice. I don't know. I don't know if that might help.
Yes, I agree. And I think a lot of that happens subconsciously. We don't actually think about that process that we're going through. But yes, I do believe that it can affect greatly how we receive things. Go ahead, Christina.
I was also going to say it can be helpful to have a face-to-face with them to get a feel of their personality. Several of the authors I've worked with do live in my town, so we have had a lot of in-person meetings, and you can get a sense if someone is a little bit more aggressive, or they have kind of a little bit more edge to their personality. That can be good to know too when you start to give them feedback, and it does help. I think it does help that they know you and they get a sense of who you are. And it's fun too. I mean, in, at least in in the town where you live, to start making connections and personal connections.